You're listening to TalkSlamRadio.com. From our studios to the world, we bring you the finest in quality entertainment. So grab a beverage, put out the Do Not Disturb sign, and settle in for another fine show from TalkSlamRadio.com.
What the hell, woman?
I'm telling you, girl. It's been, can you hear me?
Can you hear me now?
Can you hear me? Hello.
Can you hear me now?
Yeah.
There you go. I tell you, we had last week off because we were doing some beautification, and let me tell you, it does look beautiful.
Wow. We walked in.
We've got plants. Like, we have new chairs.
More mics. And
we do.
I can't believe all the chairs.
I know. We have an abundance of chairs.
We've got like a major change in, you know, look at all these mics sitting around.
If someone's trying to come in our door.
Ooh, I wonder who that is.
I don't know.
God knows, there's no telling. But it could be all the guys from Freaky Tiki.
I know. Hey, what's up with that? Hey, I want to give a shout out to our power line, helicopter flying, keep us with our lights on. Guys, let me tell you, we met some really cool people over Freaky Tiki.
Those guys were awesome.
They were so cool.
You know, let me see. I took a photo.
We took a few photos. They'll be up on our Facebook later tonight.
I'm trying to. They're called the MRY Group.
MYR.
MYR. Yeah.
And I can see it from over there.
MYR Group, but you know, these guys are hanging from helicopters.
I know, that was amazing.
Flying through the air and being put up on high rise scaffolds and 250 feet up in the air. That was amazing what they were showing us.
You know what? I think maybe we should do that job for a day. That'd be a what the hell.
That would be a what the hell, but you can do it.
I'm afraid of heights.
I'm afraid of heights, so I don't think I could do that. Honestly, and this guy, it shows the helicopter picking him up from a harness, and he's flying through the air with, really, he had no protection.
No, he had none. He said he didn't strap himself on until he got to where he had to be, and I'm like, what happens if you fall off on your way up? This is when he was climbing like a monkey up the scaffolding.
He said that doesn't happen.
That hasn't happened. I'm like, yet.
I mean, but that was amazing. So kudos out to those guys. Super, super nice guys.
They were super, super nice guys.
Yeah, very, very nice. And they loved our guest coming on tonight.
They did. Because, you know, we've been kind of secretive about who we are having. And I know you're excited. I am so excited.
I am ecstatic.
We are.
We are special girls because
we are.
ESPN has been trying to get Wayne Fox.
I know. And we got him.
We got him for our little What the Hell radio show.
I know.
And ESP
N
couldn't get him.
Nope.
We've got him.
No, we've got Wayne Fonts. He is the former Detroit Lions coach and the former Tampa Bay defensive lineman coach. We are so excited to have him. He's back there hanging with everybody, just enjoying himself.
The studio is ecstatic in here. They're wanting to talk to him about
yeah, look at him.
Stuff.
Go,
yeah.
go, 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 go,
go.
No, they're very excited.
And what a he's such a great guy.
He's an amazing guy. You know, he's been a very dear friend of ours for a while. And he comes to the Zone, your bar, the Zone Lounge. He comes there and he brings his friends. But let me tell you, he has been just an amazing, true, genuine friend to us.
He's genuine. He's not full of, you know, just a bunch of smoke and mirrors.
We're very happy. We are so happy. But you know what? Last week we didn't have the show because they were doing the beautification. And we had some exciting things that went on. We were down shooting our show. We were on Clearwater Beach at Hogan's Beach Shop. We were down there doing that. That was pretty cool. You know, it was very windy. We got out of the car and we had to get like anchored to the ground.
I mean, it was so windy. You couldn't even really stand up straight. But no. Hulk Hogan was super nice. And
he gave a little girl a new leg.
Yeah, and I think that was Steve Chamberlain.
Yes,
and
his 50 Legs. Yeah, his 50 Legs charity, which is an amazing organization.
Yeah, that's a very, that's a very nice thing to do for little kids. But
and then they had the ribbon cutting, and then Hulk picked up the little girl and had her help him cut the ribbon.
Yeah.
It was amazing.
Yeah, and CEO, who, the mayor asked permission. CEO asked permission. The mayor asked permission to cut the ribbon. So that was kind of funny that day at down there doing all that, the ribbon cutting, where they asked CEO.
I don't remember that happening.
Yeah, it did. But it was a great day.
It was an amazing day. Yeah. It was an amazing day.
Yeah.
We had so much fun. It was very windy. That's all I kept remembering, is it was so freaking windy out there.
Hair was,
and the dog.
Like,
what was that dog's name that bowed? And he kept licking my feet, though. That was like
$35,000 poodle.
That's what I heard. But the dog kept wanting to lick my feet. So I got my feet. Oh, I got my foot licked by a $35,000
dog. But you know what? He does, the guy that owned him, and I can't think of the name of.
He does a lot of charity functions.
Yeah, he does for children.
Yes.
And he sits up on chairs, and it was great. So all that is on our, our what the hell. But
wow.
It was a fantastic day.
No, it was. It was a really good day. And let's see here. What else has been going on with us?
We've had a lot going on, girl. You know what? One door closes, and we've had one door to close.
Oh, my God.
And we've had two doors to open for us.
Oh, that's right. We have a pretty big announcement. It's we're not going to let it out right now.
Yeah.
We're signing paper, dotting all our I's and crossing all our T's. But we're very, very excited and very grateful about the opportunities that have come to us.
Yes.
And I'm excited.
One door will close, and we've had two doors to open, and our little radio show here, and
I love our little radio show.
I love the studio and coming in and doing all the things.
I think I'm gonna miss when it goes from a little radio show,
because it's growing and it's starting to get big. But, lots of opportunities, opportunities for Nolan, lots of opportunities out there, for us. And, the thing about it is that we, like you said, dot our I's and cross our T's. We've just had a huge door to open for us. And, we just have to,
walk through it.
Walk through it and make sure all the legalities of everything are good.
We got it, girl. All right. So everybody now, everyone can stop guessing. It is Wayne Fonts, the incredible, amazing, wonderful Wayne Fonts.
From Detroit Lions.
We are so excited to have him in the studio. We're going to be bringing him here in a couple minutes. We're going to take our infamous, 5-minute potty break, because, we just ran over from Freaky Tiki.
Oh, my God, from Freaky Tiki.
What the hell?
Let me tell you what's happened to me.
Yeah, real quickly, let's go over. Okay. Your glasses saga.
So my $1,500 glasses that I normally wear, because my other glasses break. I have my
I don't
my
think
glasses.
I even have. Glassware in my house.
Well,
that adds
because
up to
I have all different lenses or whatever. Oh, okay. So my little black glasses that I used to always wear, I was cleaning the lens and I broke those in half. Well, I've tried to super glue them, but that's not working. So
should we wrap some tape around it? That would
be
attractive.
Well, that might have to be the next
some electrical tape, because it's black.
I might have to do that. So then the other night, after Tuesday night of filming and shooting with Anthony up at the club, I had put my glasses down, didn't realize my curling iron was on, and I set my glasses down in front of it, and it burnt my lens. But I didn't realize it till the next day when I woke up and I had this circle. And I couldn't see. And I was like, what the hell is wrong with my glasses?
I know. I remember you calling me saying, I've got this circle in the middle of my freaking glasses.
Yeah.
And I'm like, huh?
So I've got two pair of glasses now that are messed up. Wow. And to replace the lens on my other one is over $500. So I have another set ordered. And I'm just having a really hard time with glasses this week.
Well, I'm glad it's the only hard time we've had this week. We're very grateful for that.
You know what? Hey, that's that's minor and minute because we can always replace somebody.
You know what, girl? This is going to be one of our best. Actually, I think this is going to be our best show tonight. I'm so excited about being here.
You know what? I love Wayne Ponce. What a great guy.
He's an amazing guy. We're going to get ready. We're going to go to break. We're going to take this little break right now. We have our hey, say hi.
Well, hello.
Hi, honey. That's our engineer. Introduce yourself.
My name is Adam.
Hello, Adam.
Hi, Adam.
We are so happy to have you here, too. We haven't left you out. We're so excited.
Well, I'm happy to be part of the show now.
Well, thank you.
You are part of the show now. You're always going to be a part of the show now, right?
Yeah, I'm here all the time.
I know you're stuck with us.
Nolan's going to drive him. He's going to be a slave driver for the rest of the time.
All right, well, if you can line up our next song and take us out of here so we can go and do our pee-pee dance, and then we'll be back with Wayne Ponce. Thanks for joining us. Please call us 727-597-4022 if you've got any questions. And, of course, you can visit us on our Facebook page. Go to What the Hell Nation.
Job, got nothing to do. I wanna rock and roll all night. Can't pull this guitar in my hand to pay the bills on time. Need a whiskey, I'll feel alright. Gonna get drunk Monday night. Let's go! 48, big red light. The price of gas is high. Wanna roll a diamond back just. We'll be right back.
All right, are we okay? Let's do a little mic check. Check. All right, Coach, your turn.
Testing one.
Oh yeah, we can hear you. Put your phone on.
Is that?
I know. We did make you do
testing,
this.
Testing.
Oh yeah, there
hello,
you go.
Hello.
Hey. Hello.
Testing.
All right. Okay, we can start our show now. What the hell?
What the hell, woman? Is this her music? Who's music?
Okay.
Oh, our mics.
Well, this is what they play at NFL games. It runs through the whole stadium to get everybody.
Oh, no,
remember
this?
Do you remember being on the sidelines listening to this, Coach, when they played Crazy Train? Come on.
I was on the side, I heard nothing but boo.
Boo? No, you didn't. No, you didn't.
I didn't hear music. I heard boo.
There's no way.
I kept hearing, get rid of that guy.
There is no way. All right, everybody. We are
fire
back.
The coach. That's all I heard. You know, I like this type of show. I might just keep interrupting as we go. I might host this show before it's over.
Oh, hey, you know what? We've been there, done that. It's okay. We'd love to have you.
You know what?
Listen, you guys
come
know.
On.
I mean, if everybody out there, you don't know how lucky I am sitting between these two lovely
ladies.
No,
you don't know how lucky we are to have you between us.
Well, this is very nice.
We are so excited. Okay, everybody, you've tuned in. You've been waiting. You want to know who our special guest is. Here he is. In person, this is
Ta-da.
Wayne Font. He is our dear friend. We love you.
We love you, Coach.
We love Coach.
Very few. I need all the love I can get, ladies.
No, we love you. You're an amazing, amazing person. But you know what? Thank you so much. I'm telling you, we have been hounding you for, or I should say, I've been hounding you for how long to do the show? Relentlessly.
You know, the only reason why I'm doing this show
is because
I was tired of getting hounded. My God, I couldn't sleep at night. I couldn't drive down the road. I thought you guys were following me.
It wasn't that bad.
Well, it probably could have got a lot worse.
Yeah. You know, and I used to go to, go to their nightclub. Mm-hmm. And I get hounded at the nightclub.
Yeah,
we did it in a subtle way. We dance with you and we sing with
they never dance with you. I'll say that for you. But ladies, I'm glad to be here.
No, we are so glad to have
you. I'm glad to be anywhere. You know what I'm saying?
we were always nice about it.
I thought. We were always really nice.
Yeah, you had a lot of class. You two ladies had nothing but class.
Thank you.
I'm very glad to be here.
Thank you.
I'm clowning around a little bit, but
we are.
This is a very, very comfortable show.
It is.
The air conditioning's finally on. I was getting a little
were
hot.
I think it's us, though.
I mean, you guys pay the rent?
Oh, absolutely,
okay.
We do.
We're part of paying the rent.
We got to
write a check tonight for part of the rent.
Yeah. But we got that. We've got that.
Yeah, we got that.
All right, what do you want to talk about, ladies? Let's get down.
You know what? Let's talk about. Hold on. Let's first do a little.
Let's do a little cheer.
Let's do a little cheer.
Thank you for coming on.
Thank you.
We love you.
Cheers. Oh, hey.
Iced tea.
I think tonight. No, it's flavored water.
Flavored and colored water.
Right,
yeah,
water.
We put limes and lemon.
Yeah, in our flavored water.
Yeah,
I think tonight's election night.
You know what? I'm very interested in the election. I'm not telling anybody who I voted for, but I voted this morning. It's our right.
Yes.
And everybody should vote.
Absolutely.
Yes, absolutely.
And it's going to be a close election, and may the better man win.
I just hope whoever wins can do something with this economy the way that it's been. It's been tough.
It's very tough. But whoever wins, the thing about the American people, and it's very important, whoever wins, we have to back that person.
Exactly. Yes.
Regardless if you're Republican or Democrat, mm-hmm. whatever it is, whoever wins,
mm-hmm.
we have to get together and back that person.
Exactly. Yep. It's been tough. It's been tough for, I mean, I have felt it in my business as along with a lot of other business owners, but you know, this is what I said. Whoever, you know,
we need to back our country. Is
yeah,
what it is.
We do. You know? We do exactly. So it's.
Put our differences aside, but I hope the best man wins tonight.
Well, I hope the guy I voted for wins.
Me too.
Can I keep? This thing's falling off my head.
Yes.
Go ahead. Let's keep talking, though.
Okay.
I got it now.
Oh, you got it?
It feels good now.
It feels
good now.
It was slipping down on my chin.
What the hell? What the hell, Wayne?
All right, listen. How about them Bucks?
Let me tell you. You know what? The Bucks have been near and dear to me. I am a Florida-grown girl, okay? And I remember being a little girl, and it was the name the team. And then growing up, my grandparents, they had a company and that my mom worked for. But anyhow, we had season tickets.
Yeah.
We had really good season tickets. And this is back in the old Sombrero with the bench seating, and you'd bring your chair and you would connect it onto it because it didn't have any, you know, you had to bring your chair with a back on it.
I remember the day.
Yeah, remember those days? I mean, we had like really good seats. And let me tell you, we couldn't give them away. And there was like nobody in the stands. It was crazy. I was a little girl. I didn't appreciate it back then. I was like, no, do I have to go to the football game? But no.
You're a mere child when I was coaching there. I was coaching there in 1976 when the Bucs started. NFL franchise. I was one of the first coaches here with John McKay.
Because you were there for 2 years.
No, I coached the Bucs for 10 years.
Was it 10 years?
Yeah, it's a defensive. You were a defensive line coach.
No, I was defensive backfield
defensive
coach.
Defensive back, yeah. Okay.
And then I became.
I was close. Defensive something.
Defensive something.
Hey, we're not sports girls, but yeah. Hey, we're playing well, along. We're playing along.
Well, listen, in the write-up it said 2 years.
But they were close.
Yeah.
But I mean, back in the day, and the people have to understand that back in the day when John McKay became the head coach of Tampa Bay Buccaneers.
I did love him.
Well, great man. And the thing was that we were an expansion team. Back mm-hmm. then, there were no free agents.
Mm-hmm.
So when we lined up to play, well, we got players from other teams mm-hmm. that they didn't want.
Right.
I remember players flying in to work out with us. They were blind, crippled, and crazy. I mean, I'm serious.
What the
hell? I'm very serious. I mean, guys come in.
So is that how we ended up with Buccaneer Bruce as our mascot? What the hell?
We had guys, and we would tell them to get short, someone want to work out. They would go in there, they have scars on their legs, they couldn't walk, they would have bandaged them up. I mean, it was amazing that we fielded a team.
And they expected mm-hmm. you to turn them into something amazing.
Oh, absolutely. The team turned them into something that no one else did.
Right.
But it was amazing, the transformation that back then the team took. It was a situation where John McKay, they drafted Leroy Selman.
I was going to say, you right. were back with Leroy Selman.
Yeah.
What an amazing man he was. Oh, my
you
God.
You know what? Not a finer person mm-hmm. that you ever want to meet other than the guy I coached also in Detroit.
Leroy
Selman was
Barry?
The best.
You talking about Barry?
We'll talk about Barry.
Okay, we'll talk about
over.
Okay.
But Leroy Selman was one fine gentleman, and we had a good football team. We slowly built it, and the fans backed it then. Mm-hmm. And the thing I'm getting to right now is we came close to going through the Super Bowl. We lost.
You did.
We lost to the Rams,
mm-hmm.
Or we went to the Super Bowl that mm-hmm. year, and we had beat the Rams in regular season. People might have forgotten. It was like we beat them, I think, 6 or 9-6 or something of that nature, and they beat us in the final to go to the Super Bowl, like 3-0 or 6-0, whatever it
was. Right, right.
So we had a good football team. But you take that team, and now you look at the Tampa Bay Buccaneers now. Mm-hmm. Buccaneers now. And it, the sad thing is I go to every game.
Yeah.
I'm a big-time Tampa
That's
Bay.
That's a great thing.
Am I just talking too much here?
No, you go right ahead.
You understand.
I love
the Buccaneers. I could listen to stories all day, all night. I was just over there, as a matter of fact. I love them.
Where were you, the locker room? Where were you?
No, I was actually at the brand new One Buck
where
in the locker
she?
Room.
Where was she?
No.
She might want to be in the locker room, but no.
No wonder they're coming out of their legs a little worried. I don't know.
I don't want to be in that locker room. I'm assuming it's really stinky in there.
Well, you know, it's a lot of sweat going on in there.
Yeah, no, I actually was in brand new Buck Place, and I was in the lunchroom, which is amazing. And I got to watch, as I was eating lunch, everybody working out and training, and then they'd get on the elliptical and on the bicycle, and they're, like, right there in the window, and they're running around. And
well,
I was like,
turn you on.
Well, I'm going to tell you right now, it was not, the day did not suck. The day didn't suck.
It was a great day.
But then, I got to go over to the stadium and get out and walk on the field.
Well, that was nice.
Oh, my God.
A lot of people like to do that.
Oh, my God. No, I loved to do that.
You take your shoes off, walk on the grass.
You know, I was running, and I was going to do this whole touchdown thing, and they wanted me to roll, and I wasn't going to happen.
Gentlemen, if you can see these two ladies, they would have trouble rolling.
It'd be a wobble roll.
Okay, so let's get back to you because I want to hear all this. I love these stories about the Tampa Bay Buccaneers.
Well, you know, and when we were coaching at the Tampa Bay Buccaneers back in the day when I was there, the facility was archaic. Mm-hmm. We had a locker room for the coaches. We had like 7 coaches, and we had a little small shower area and 4 showers for 7 guys. You had to wait, take mm-hmm. turns to go in there, and you turn it on, the water would go.
Oh, I mean, wow, there was no power. Really? Wow.
There was no power. You go like, you throw your arm up real quick, try to get something, you know. It was that bad. And it had and it had one stool. I mean, it was an archaic locker room for guys. I mean, I don't know if
is this in the stadium?
Yeah, in the Bucks locker room.
Oh my gosh!
In our Bucks facility where the players practice way back when one Buck place.
Yeah,
but the reason why I brought that up.
Are you talking about the trailers that were alongside where now International Mall is?
But the thing that I brought that up because now their new facility is second to none.
Oh my God, it's beautiful, state of the art.
Oh God!
I took an entire tour. I was down in the room where they view the film. Those chairs are huge. They hold 500 pounds each.
What she's saying, and what she's saying is absolutely correct. They're theater chairs.
They are. Wow. No, they're not. No, they're like a double wide, but they're for one person because they hold 500 pounds.
You can sit in those chairs like this and sit back and
they're and they
rock.
They do. They look at their films. Nice.
They're in like a movie theater. Mm-hmm. I mean, for people that have never been in that, I mean, the locker room and the facilities, the One Buck Place, they're amazing. I mean, when we were at the old One Buck Place, we had not even high school chairs.
We had the table that's connected to the...
We had junior high chairs, and the guys were trying to get into them. They would slide into them, and once they got into them, they couldn't get out. They had to stand up, and they would walk out with the chair.
Oh, my God. That's so funny.
Wow. These are things...
That came a long way.
These are people things don't know. People don't know these things. Yeah.
Was Scott Brantley there when you were there?
Scott Brantley was there, and another outstanding player.
You know what? He's a very, very dear. I haven't spoken to him in a while. Very dear friend of mine from way back. What an amazing man! I know he's had some struggles and everything with his health, and God bless him. I hope that everything works out for him. But what an amazing individual! And
class.
I got to meet his mother, who made the most amazing biscuits and gravy I've ever had in my life. That's all I'm going to say.
Biscuits and gravy.
Is that a story for later? Are we going to hear that story later?
Yeah, maybe later.
Nice biscuits.
No, she made the most amazing biscuits and gravy I've ever had in my entire life.
Oh, my sinny.
It was.
Was she like from the South?
She is. She's from Southern.
That's a Southern thing. My mother makes awesome biscuits
But I'm telling
and gravy.
You, that team, you know, that team back then, I think it was the prelude to what then happened when you got the All-Star, the John Lynch. You know, I think it was a setup for that whole organization.
Mm-hmm. Absolutely correct. And those guys, the Brantleys and the Selmans and the Doug Williams. Yeah. And I could go on and on.
What
and
a
on
good
and name all those old guys that were there when I was there. But they set up something that the Bucks need the fans to come back.
Right.
To.
They do.
Right.
And people, let me tell you this, the Bucks are a fine football team. Mm-hmm. Make no mistakes about it. Mm-hmm. They're well coached. Coach Siano's done a great job with them. Their coaching staff is outstanding. Mm-hmm. You see a lot of discipline in this football mm-hmm. team. You see a team that's not bickering on a sideline. You see a football team that's there to work. Mm-hmm. They're a type of football team that when I was the head coach of Detroit, when they walk across that white line to go to practice, they go to work.
They go to work.
So they do. I watched them practice the other day, and they didn't stop. They still were practicing when I left after a 2-hour lunch. They were still practicing.
I go there and watch. I go to eat lunch, and then I look out the window because it was hot. So I just watch, and then I get cookies, and I leave. But that's what you could do.
You remember those days don't you?
That's what you could do when you retire.
Exactly. You've had an amazing life, though.
Oh, yeah.
You really have.
You've had an amazing career.
You know, and when I left Tampa Bay, years in 1983, I can't remember, it's been so long ago, I wanted the job here, and I was promised to be the next head coach of the Tampa Bay Buccaneers when John McKay was leaving.
Mm-hmm.
And I didn't get the job. And it was heartbreaking. It was very, very difficult for me to even get up and for me to even do an interview after I didn't get the job. But like, you know, and people say, and they shut one door and
opened another door.
That's right.
And, we are firm believers in
that. I went to Detroit and everything happened for me there.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
And I was very fortunate to be able to coach one of the best players in the history of this game, Barry Sanders.
Yes, you did.
So,
and he admired you. He believed in what your system. He believed in what you were doing.
He was the only guy that didn't want me fired.
I wasn't gonna.
That's a lot of controversy.
But you know, I was there a long time. I was there 8 years.
You were.
You know when you're one. You know when you're one place at a long time. Like if your girls do the show for a long time, they're gonna say, "What else can they say?"
Right.
I remember my 8th year. I'd get up in front of the press and I'd say, "It's just a win."
Right.
Well, it's just a loss. You know, yeah.
What the hell? What do you want me to say?
Yeah.
It's another game. It's another Sunday.
Say, right. You know what I mean?
Right. But, you got a couple of nicknames, though, didn't you? Through your career.
Well, let's not hold us. Be careful what we say. Are we on the air?
No. Or internet radio. We can talk about those.
No, you had a couple cute ones there.
You did.
I don't know. Let's not go into it. But anyway, I'm glad to be here, girls. And we could talk about the Lions forever because. Barry Sanders, Chris Spielman, Leroy Salmon, Doug Williams. You could always say one thing about Barry, that he was a better person. If you could understand these people, Barry Sanders was a better person than he was a player. That's what a class guy he
was.
That's a nice thing to say.
You know,
he was class. And Leroy Salmon was that way. Doug Williams is the Mark Cotleys. I can name a bunch of guys like that. Things have changed now.
Yeah.
I think money has influenced the game a little more than it should. But you know, it's a violent.
Now let's talk about the violence of it, because there's a lot of controversy about the concussions, about the head injuries, and what they're talking about of the long-term effects. Because it's starting to come out that they're with the concussions that they've received. That there are these long-term effects, and there are people who are standing up and trying to organize and trying to. Now, what do you think about that? Because you were a football player.
Oh, absolutely.
Yeah. Before all this happened, upon a time, were a football player.
Don't date me that bag. Once upon a time, my God.
I didn't mean it about. Hey, have you ever seen the Cinderella story? That's a beautiful thing, baby.
Let me tell you this. I got an email from the person that is getting all the players to come in. He's representing all the players with concussions, et cetera.
Right. Well, Gay Culverhouse is really heading up this thing.
I don't think it's gay. But anyway.
Well, no, I'm just saying Gay Culverhouse, she's really spearheading a lot of this, right?
Wow. Yeah. I didn't know that.
You didn't know that?
No, not at all.
I haven't heard that.
But anyway, I'm surprised how much you really know.
Well,
you're just not a pretty face.
Well, no, I'm actually very intelligent. Don't tell anybody. It's my little secret. And what I do in my day job, I'm very cognizant of that. So
that's a good word.
Yeah, it is. That's a good word.
Anyhow, let's get back to.
I got email from the attorney that's representing all these players. Evidently, he went back and checked, I guess, when I played. I broke my leg and tore my Achilles tendon, and I was out. So they said, you know, if all these people are players that got hurt or are coming in and they want a case, I'm saying, no, it's been too long ago for me, and I would never do that anyway. But there are a lot of players that are saying, hey, they have got a lot of problems.
Yeah, they do.
And sometimes when I stutter, I say, maybe I have some too. You know?
Just be us.
There's no question about that.
I'm just joking. But
I mean, when you go into that, you know going into that, there's going to be injuries and you know, a lot of things that are going to happen as a player. You know,
what is the lifespan of a player?
Yeah.
You know, I'm not talking about I'm talking about playing lifespan, not like life, living. But
I think it all depends what position
you're
in.
Yeah. Quarterback, they could play forever because aren't they protected?
No, quarterback can go down quickly. Running backs probably less than anyone. Wide receivers, somebody that comes across the middle, guy carries a football, quarterbacks, some quarterbacks are very lucky. They don't get knocked out every game.
Right.
But
we've seen some pretty serious hits. As a matter of fact, there's a big controversial hit over last weekend.
Yes, there was. It was you and I and who else that we got hit?
Was down. Like they showed him, and he was like
what game was it?
The ground, like flipping around.
What game was it?
I don't remember right now.
Do you recall?
No, I don't.
All right. It's enough of you. All right, now.
You tell us. You're the football expert.
You would know. You're at all the games.
No, you know what? I go to the Bucks game, I watch the Bucks play. Mm-hmm. And if the Lions are on TV, I watch the Lions play. Mm-hmm. I'm not one of these guys that are hung up on watching every game. I'm not one of these guys that are in football fantasy leagues. I don't do that. If you ask me who played for Jacksonville, I have no idea. Mm-hmm. Who plays for Miami, I have no idea. If there's a John Wayne movie on and the Bucks are done playing and the Lions are playing tonight, I watch a John Wayne movie instead of watching Oakland playing Philadelphia.
Right.
I'm not one of these guys that are hung up on just sitting there and having a cocktail in my hand and going to a bar and watching a football game.
There's a lot of men like that. Right.
Well, I know, and maybe it's because I've been in it so long, I played so long, and I found out that there are other things in life, mm-hmm. you know, like my family and my kids and grandkids mm-hmm. and. So
you're here in Tarpon Springs now. You've made Tarpon your home.
Oh yeah,
for a while now.
I've been in Tarpon Springs 14 or 15 years now, and it's a quiet. Fishing village.
Quite little town.
With a drinking problem.
Wait a minute.
Is that what's wrong with us?
What's the problem?
Excuse me while I sip on this iced tea.
Tarpon is an amazing place. You know, it's a very unique and eclectic Greek community.
Is.
It's a fishing village. It used to be a fishing village. Yeah. I mean, it still has some amazing seafood. The food is actually all the food.
Yeah,
Zante's though.
Have you been to Zante's? No.
Will you go to dinner with us one night?
Oh, absolutely.
Okay, we're gonna take you to Zante's.
Where's it located?
Cajun Greek Creole.
Where's it located?
It's right up on Tarpon Avenue.
Yeah, right behind her club.
It's a very unique little restaurant that.
It looks like you're walking to a garage sale.
Wait a minute. Wait a minute, for the fans that the listeners that don't know, Tarpon Avenue, take a left right there at the trail.
Yes, at the trail.
Right
take
at
a
the
right.
Trail.
Take a
you
right
know where
at the trail.
The Tarpon Tavern is right now.
Yes.
Okay.
It's right next
it's
to
It's right
it.
On that little road, but it's a very unique
it's
dining
Cajun.
Experience.
I heard
Cajun.
About that.
It
part.
Is so yummy. We
I heard about that.
We'll mm-hmm. take you to dinner there one night.
Okay,
it is so good.
You would really enjoy it.
And it's a family. They have the whole family from the like mom and dad to the kids working this restaurant.
I used to go there when the little boy was this high and he thought he was in Star Wars and he'd swing his wand. And as I was ordering, he would swing his wand. And I'm like, okay. When you walk in, and there would be a baby crib over there.
Now the boy's asking you out, probably.
And now
probably.
He's,
leaving her flowers on her car.
Yeah, you know, but it's the family that owns it are super nice people, and kids work it, and
the food is amazing.
The food is amazing. He's from New Orleans, but they opened up a little store, boutique or something. But a nice family, another family up there that such a great restaurant and such a unique dining experience. But they're all, you know, it's been a little. It'd be nice to go up there.
I've heard about it, and maybe we need to check it out.
Yeah. No, we do.
Enjoy it. And the food is, like she said, is excellent.
It is excellent.
You'll want to go back there.
All right. Long time we have here. But
no, we're good. We're good.
I'll tell you, this, going back to violence.
Yes.
I keep thinking about it. And for you people that just watch the game, and for women that watch the game, football is probably one of the best policed game that's played. I mean, the commissioner watches it. Mm-hmm. You can't do this. You can't do drugs.
Right.
You do it, you get. But it's a violent. Football is a violent game because the players are so big.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
And they're getting faster every year.
Yes, they are.
Now, how big is your average play, like a lineman?
The average lineman in the national offensive lineman are much bigger than defensive linemen. The average offensive lineman may be 6'5" on a small size.
Wow.
6'5", maybe 280 small, 350, 345.
And you don't 50. Realize how big they are.
When not on TV.
You don't are watching TV. You don't really realize how big
from
they are.
From the 1,000-foot view.
Exactly. Yeah.
Oh,
they
absolutely.
Look small.
When I came to Tarpon Springs, I met a lot of people since I've been here and a lot of friends. And they said, my God, we thought you were a little short guy. And I
and
said,
you're not.
Because,
you're not. You're a tall man.
I'm not a tall man, but I'm big enough, you know.
You're a tall man.
But, you know, but these guys are so big. I mean, I'm 6 foot tall. These guys are 6'6", 6'5". Mm-hmm. Wide receivers now are 6 foot four, 6'5".
Wow.
And they all could run.
Yeah.
And
quickly,
and,
too.
Yes. And there's a place now for the little guy. Before, years ago, no one wanted the little guy.
Mm-hmm.
And the
work
little,
done.
And,
how
and
about
the,
work
oh,
done?
Oh, yeah. The little guy now is proving he can play. The running back from the Buccaneers.
Yeah.
My God, that guy had one of the great games. And he's only 5 foot nine, 200 yeah. maybe 15, 14
mm-hmm.
pounds.
Mm-hmm.
He had
that's
a great
a big
game
boy,
against the
yeah.
Raiders.
Yeah. Yeah.
So there's a place for everybody to play in football. And I like football because it's a police game. I mean, you can't do this, you can't do that. And every time a person gets in trouble, he's out to 2 in the morning.
Mm-hmm.
He's at a bar at 3 in the morning.
Mm-hmm.
And, only thing that happens when you're out that late is trouble.
Right. Mm-hmm.
Why,
right.
If you can't get it done before midnight, go home. I mean,
that's true. That,
I mean, whatever.
That's
no,
true.
I mean,
exactly.
Whatever it is. I mean, no, whatever. If you can't eat, before midnight. You can't play cards. Get the card game over. Go see your buddies. But if you can't get it done before midnight, go home.
Wow. You know what? That's going to be our new theme.
That is.
If you can't get
good.
It done before midnight, go home.
Go home. That's good, Coach.
Because every athlete, they just say football, but every uh-huh. athlete you read in the paper, he's at a bar at 2:30 in the morning. He was over the gunshot, went off at 1:15. He was speeding, going home drunk at 12:45. Go home.
Now, let me ask you something. What control, if any, does the team, the coach, the owner, the management have over these players? Is there anything?
No. I mean, you can't tell a grown man, what time to go home. You have curfews mm-hmm. during the season, during mini camp, mm-hmm. During practice, during the camp before season starts. You put him in a hotel. Wherever you put them up, we had curfews. Like I had my guys after dinner, we'd practice and we go to dinner. After dinner, we have meetings. Mm-hmm. And I would tell my coaches to keep them in meetings as long as they can. As long as they can, so they don't, and because they had to be in bed at 10, had to be in the
right,
room at 10.
Right.
Keep them busy.
Had
keep
to be in
busy.
10. So
keep
them
busy.
Let
busy.
Them out at 9. If they can't get done in an hour, they're coming back. You know what I mean?
It's hard to do something within the hour sometimes.
In an hour, you get a chance to say, well, hello, how are you? I got to go.
Exactly.
You know,
that's
one of those
exactly
type of deals.
Right.
So you try to keep them out of trouble. But once the season starts, they go home.
Yeah.
And it's hard to police them when they're home, other than the night before a game. Then again, you put them in a hotel.
Mm-hmm.
And then they're in bed at 10 or whatever, and they're watching TV till midnight, whatever it is. But it's something you just can't control, and the guy has to take it upon himself.
To
behave.
Responsible.
Yeah, to be responsible.
Yeah,
they make so much money.
Yeah.
Why are you going to go out and mess that up?
Mess it up.
Oh,
exactly.
God.
What do you think about the salary cap?
The reason why I like it is it kind of evens up all teams.
Mm-hmm.
It gives a chance like a team like Green Bay. Who wants to go to Green Bay Packers? You'd rather go to Green Bay Packers or you'd rather go to L.A.?
Right.
Where do you want to live?
Hey, I hear when you're born in Green Bay, they put a Green Bay Packer diaper on you and that you go on the waiting list for tickets.
Well, that's a possibility. But, you know, I'm not knocking Green Bay, but Green Bay is a great football town. It is one of the best. But if you're sitting there and you're a free agent
mm-hmm.
and you have a chance to go to New York,
mm-hmm.
L.A., San Diego, or Sam's Corner, where are you going?
Right.
Yeah, you're going to go to a high market place.
Right.
You go to Green Bay because there's a lot of tradition there.
Mm-hmm.
But some of these other teams, you don't have doesn't have a chance. But you have to have money.
Right.
And you talked about the cap.
Yeah.
Everybody spends the same amount of money.
Okay.
I mean, the Rams don't spend any more money than the Bucks do. It's just how you spend it.
Okay.
How you distribute it. Who you're giving the most money to.
Mm-hmm.
So that which makes football kind of even.
But then, what about the draft, like the first round picks, the second round? I mean, there's some teams that, are they not getting a a little bit more leverage?
A first round pick deserves most of the money.
Yeah.
And he'll get it, especially if he's a quarterback.
Right.
But after that, once the first guy chosen is paid, all the other guys that are drafted, they start to sign their contracts because they're all going to get a little bit less.
He set the bar.
He sets the bar.
He sets the bar. Okay.
He sets the bar. That's where to put it. He sets the bar.
Okay. Do you think we'll ever see females in the NFL?
I remember one time we were in a meeting and they brought it up.
Mm-hmm.
How high their shorts or skirts should be as cheerleaders.
Right.
You know, so we see females as cheerleaders.
No, I'm not saying I want to see a female on the field. I'm just asking.
Are you mind?
So what the hell? I'm just saying, what the hell? Hey, we got some female hockey players. I don't know. We had a goalie. It was female.
I mean, those guys take a beating. I don't know if the women could.
A kicker. A kicker. A punter.
Yeah.
Punter.
Football players are like basketball players. They go to college. Some of them don't even go to college, and they go right into pros, basketball players.
Mm-hmm.
You get an 18-year-old basketball player from high school, and like LeBron James.
Mm-hmm.
He goes on, he's one of the best players in basketball, probably one of the best maybe of all time. And it's hard to compare him with the other guys, but he's great. But you can't take an 18-year-old kid from high school and put him in the NFL.
Right.
He would get hurt.
Yeah.
His body's not developed.
Right.
It's a different, the conditioning.
And
it's a different. I don't care how great he is. He's 18. It's different.
Yeah.
Playing football.
Well, you know what? We only have 3 minutes left.
Well,
how did the time go by?
Did that fly by?
Well, you know, it's been a long time since I've been sitting in his chair. No.
We want you to come back. Wasn't this fun?
We promised you
that this would be very relaxed and just, you know, a fun night. Was this not fun?
I want to come. It was absolutely.
I think he needs his own show.
Hey, wait a minute. Yeah. What the hell?
I'm going to come back and help host this show with these ladies.
I think you should.
Whenever we get some guests, I'm going to come back.
You know what?
We would love you.
You know
to
what?
Come
we would
anytime.
Love for you to be our co-host. We need a guy. We don't have our guy. You're our guy.
Are you looking at him?
You want to be our guy?
Well, your guy.
Okay, you're our guy. You heard it.
No.
You absolutely heard it.
No, I want to say kudos out to Doug. This Friday and Saturday, Doug Canny, who is one of the comedians, and he's one of our friends. And he is at Coconuts in Jack's Joint Clearwater this weekend. Show starts at 8 o'clock. So for anybody who wants to go see a good comedian, Doug Canny.
Go see him. Go
you can't beat the three right here.
No, you can't. You absolutely can't.
You could be a
now, Coach, is there any charities or anybody you want to recognize right now? Anybody you want for people to take a look at right now or anything?
You know what? You know, and I would love to. I can mention people. I can mention. But, you know, if you mention one person, you forget somebody
else.
Yeah,
right.
Yeah.
So I'm not one of those type of say hello to this person, say hello to that person.
Any charity or anything or any charities?
No, I stay away from all that sort of stuff.
All right, cool. We'll start our own. Actually, we have a nonprofit. I think we, you know what? I think Christmas is coming up.
You could be my charity.
Well, we could do that. We could do that.
We could do that.
We just have to wait for charity.
Exactly.
We will. But you know what? Thank you so much for being on the show. We love and adore you, and I hope you are going to be our wingman.
Well, you know, if you need me, just call me. I enjoyed it
very much. Okay, did everybody hear that?
Yes.
He just Okay.
I lie a lot now.
I don't think you do.
I think you're a good man.
I don't think you do.
And
no,
you're a sweetheart.
This was.
Well, you know, if I knew, I see myself on the screen here. I'd have wore something. I'd have been very dapper.
Well, you know what? No, you're always dapper.
Well, the next time, you can come in dapper.
Come on in dapper.
I'd look very Floridian.
There you
go. Let's do it. Let's do the whole Panama Jack. Okay. I don't know.
I'd even tinted my hair black.
Oh my God.
I was doing that to a guy the other night with a
guy looking at his cheek on the way out.
Yes.
Oh, thank you.
We love you.
Oh, you guys are missing
it. We love
you so much.
Thank you so much for being here. And everybody, we want to thank our sponsors, which are, of course, the Zone Lounge.
The Zone Lounge.
Please come out and see us.
Very, very nice place.
Thank you.
Coach hangs out with us. The Black Honkies are there every third Thursday.
Yes.
And Dee and I are there on weekends. I'm going to be, I do need you to commit to two shows. As a co-host with Dee, because I'm going to Europe for 2 weeks.
Are you crazy?
You know what? I've never been, and I can't tell you how excited I am about this
trip.
I am so excited. If you're available, would you come and co-host with Dee for the 2 weeks I'm gone?
Let's find out when it is.
Okay. I'll call you.
All right,
I'll
call
okay. you. Well, and our other
and we have Latisse, yeah, burlesque Latisse. Group this Saturday night at the Zone too.
Oh,
so
yes, come.
You know, if you're
come play with us
out and about.
Yeah,
Latisse.
And Trim Nutrition, we want to thank
the,
them.
The Tees?
La
La La La La La La Tees. La Tees.
Sexy, sexy girls.
So thank you again. This is an amazing
you
show.
Very much.
Thank you, everybody. Thank
I
you,
had
Trim
fun.
Nutrition. Thank you, Zone Lounge.
I had fun.
And thank as always, way. Sasha, good morning, good night, sweetie. And we will see you guys soon.
Good night. Thank you.
What the hell?